Hi folks, this is going to be a series of tutorials on MIDI programming, by which I mean how to write a computer program to connect to a MIDI device and manipulate its internal settings. Essentially, we are going to create a MIDI dashboard that displays the device's parameters and allows us to change them. It could look something like this. In fact, we could go a step further and add functionality that's not part of the instrument's capabilities. Like, for instance, create and playback drum sequences. My target device in this undertaking is a Roland FP30 digital piano, but much of what I'm going to say applies to any MIDI-enabled musical instrument. Of course, the feature set of the application you write will depend on the capabilities of the MIDI device you have available to play with. Interestingly, you might find, after doing some research, that your digital piano or synthesizer can do a lot more via MIDI than you thought possible by just looking at the external controls. This was the situation in my case. See, the Roland FP30 has only a few buttons and some key combinations to select voices and adjust settings, but when the internals are accessed with a program from the computer, it's a whole different world, with many additional possibilities. After this somewhat long-winded introduction, let us see what our specific goals will be in upcoming tutorials. In this video, I'll start with the essentials and we'll learn how to establish a connection with the MIDI device and display some of its particulars. We will also play some notes, sound, on it, and that is going to be the ultimate test that the program is working. Then we will write code to turn our computer keyboard into a piano keyboard so that we can produce some simple music. Additionally, we will make our connection with the device work both ways, and it will be possible to play music from the piano as well. Why that is important is because later on we will intercept the key presses in our program and manipulate it in various interesting ways. As far as the programming language is concerned, I will be coding in C#, because it looks to me that it is quite a popular language among programmers, so chances are that most of you are familiar with it. You don't have to be an expert, we will keep things simple. I'm on the Windows platform. If you are on Mac or Linux, you can still follow along and apply the corresponding or equivalent techniques to your environment. So, this is my setup. Here is the piano, and it is connected to my laptop with a USB cable. I'm running Visual Studio 2019 Community Edition, which is free, and it has everything I need, including a debugger. With all that said, let's get started at last. I create a new project, and for this first version of the program, it can be a console application to keep things simple. It doesn't really matter which of the two I select. I'll go with .NET Core. Name it MIDI Dashboard. This will end up being the namespace by default. Now, as you know, there are several layers of software between an application program and a peripheral device. And one of those layers is this API called winmm.dll. My program will talk to this API. It comes with the operating system, so no extra installation is necessary. We can reference it in our program right away. And the way to do it is to use the DLL import attribute over the method names the DLL exposes. Here are my declarations of the methods I need. These two, will tell me how many MIDI input and output devices are connected to my system. They could include software or virtual MIDI devices as well. The next two report on the capabilities of these devices. Before we can use a device, it must be opened, and we should close it after we finished using it. We will examine the function parameters in a minute. The last method of interest for the time being is MIDI out short message. MIDI out short message is used for a number of things, including playing a single musical note on the piano. There is one more thing I need to mention. In order to receive messages from the MIDI device, we need a callback function. The callback function is declared as a delegate up here, and it is called MIDI in proc, although it could have any other name. I will talk about it in more detail later. How did I know what these function names and their parameters were? Well, as with everything else, really, this can be found on the internet. For instance, in a document I downloaded some time ago. Here is the explanation of the MIDI in open function. Or here, the MIDI in proc callback function. These declarations use C syntax from long ago, and the challenge is to find the matching C# data types. That again is something one can learn from freely available information on the net, such as this. But I've done all that work for you here. A couple of comments on the parameters using MIDI out open as an example. A handle is an identifier that looks like a pointer, but it is not really a pointer. It is a value used by the API to identify the MIDI device. The handle is assigned a value by the API when the device is opened, and that is why we need to pass it by reference. And the caller, that is our program, must safekeep it and give it back to the API whenever required. It is important to use the integer pointer CLR type here, and the same when we pass a pointer to our callback function. And then there are some enumerations here, such as the possible API function return values, the MIDI callback flags, and the MIDI message types. In the case of the MIDI device capabilities API functions, we have to pass in pointers to the structures that the API fills in. The tricky item here is the name of the device, which is a string of characters traveling from an unmanaged environment to a managed one. The length of the string has to be given, and I'm told that the device name cannot be longer than 32 characters. While on the topic of character strings, by default C# uses the NC character set for marshalling. In the API, every function that has a string parameter has two versions, one for NC characters and another for wide characters. Here I'm using the NC or A versions. Now we know the interface to the API. It is time to talk about the structure of the program. The interface is encapsulated in a class called MIDI device. This is actually an abstract class, because there are two types of devices, which are subclasses, an input device and an output device. The common methods, which are in the base class, are responsible for the initial discovery of the active devices in the system. and they assign values to the object's properties like device ID and device name. However, the open and close methods are implemented in the subclasses because there are slight differences in how they work. Also, the MIDI callback function is only present in the MIDI in subclass. I named it MIDI in message handler, and in it, a switch statement catches some of the incoming MIDI messages and displays them on the console. The API is told about this callback function in the open function call. Notice that the MIDI callback variable is declared at the class level and not as a variable local to the open method, because it needs to persist. Sometimes it is easy to make that mistake. The interesting method in the MIDI out device is the one which sends a MIDI message to the device. In this first version of the program, that will be just a musical note, packed into a MIDI message. There are many different MIDI messages, and we will meet most of them in the course of our journey. A musical note is only one of those MIDI messages, and it is the simplest. Notwithstanding its simplicity, I created a class for it. Excuse me. It stores the messages parameters, the MIDI channel number, the note number, and its velocity. These are assigned values in the constructor. The MIDI musical note object is also responsible to actually sending that message to the device through the interface. Playing a musical note actually involves sending a pair of messages. To tell the MIDI device to start playing, and then to tell it to stop playing the note. As you can see, the parameters of the musical note have to be packed into a MIDI message of a certain form before it can be sent to the device. The format of the various MIDI messages will be looked at in a later tutorial. Now we are ready to run the program. First, a static class method is called to get the particulars of the connected MIDI in and output devices. These devices are stored in two lists. Then I'm just looping through these devices. And if I find a Roland device, I open it and then close it. With an input device, I expect to receive some messages through the callback routine. With an output device, I play a couple of notes on it. I run it again. It works. I'll put a link to the source code in the description. In the next video, we will make our computer keyboard act like a piano keyboard. So see you then.